Knowing the right tips and tricks can help you use Notion a lot faster. In this video, I wanted to cover 10 techniques, including keyboard shortcuts that could make your day-to-day workflow in Notion efficient and quick. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Stay tuned until the end for a free Notion shortcut cheat sheet. The first tip I have for you is to drag the column down inside of tables. So if we go ahead and type slash table to create a table view database plus new table, and let's say that we have a lot of rows, we can go ahead and type return shift all the way down like this. And then we can add a property here, which is going to be multi-select, and then we can add tag one. And let's say that everything here should be tag one, then you can go ahead and click the corner and then drag it all the way down in order to fill it in. So this is a really easy way to fill in your rows inside of tables. The next quick tip I have for you is to use tabs inside of Notion. Tabs are actually a relatively new feature, but it's really useful because you can actually have the really important pages all the way at the top. So if we go ahead and click here, plus, then we can add a new tab and you can choose what to add here. So let's say that we just want to open the use tabs, our current page as a new tab. You can do something like this so that you have two tabs here. And the other thing you can do is to pin this tab. So we can go ahead and click pin and you're always going to have that tab over here. So if you have to reference things all the time, using tabs can be a really useful feature. If you want to add a new tab, a quick shortcut is to do Command or Control T, and then you can immediately open a new tab. So let's say that we want to open up our keyboard shortcut cheat sheet. We can go ahead and open it up. And then if we wanted to go back to our use tabs, you can go here. The next quick tip I have is something more fun, and that is for emojis. So if you want to add emojis really quickly, you can simply type colon and then the name of the emoji. So if we wanted an apple, you can do that. And then you can just select the one that you want. So this is one of the quickest way to find emojis, just by doing colon and then looking for something like arrow and things like that. And also if you wanted to do slash and then look for emojis, you can also do that as well. The other way is to do control command space to do the system emoji picker like this. And that's another option if you want to add a emoji. So the other quick tip is that you can highlight blocks, and highlighting blocks can allow you to do all sorts of things, from duplicating, deleting all at once, and so on. And this is a huge time saver. So for example, if we just choose a calendar view, and this works in any kind of view, but basically if you had a bunch of these pages inside of here and you wanted to find a way to just delete them all at the same time, instead of going one by one, you can just hold your cursor, drag all the way on top, and then you can just hit delete and delete them all. So this is a really useful feature if you want to highlight everything and delete, or you can also do things like moving those pages somewhere else, or you can also copy those and then paste them somewhere else. So there's a lot you can do, but basically just remember that you can drag your cursor, hold it, and then cover everything you want to select. So the next time saver that I wanted to share with you all is to add a table of contents. So as you can see here, this course introduction and setup includes a bunch of these lessons and they all lead to different sections. So if you have a lot of text on the page, table of contents can save you a lot of time so that you don't have to endlessly scroll. The other thing is that you can go to this other side here and then see all the options, so you can go easily anywhere you want to go in the page. And if you want to set this up, all you have to do is to type slash TOC or table of contents. So you can see here, table of contents. And as long as they are in different headings, it's going to show up here. And the other thing to note is that you can turn it on by going to the three dots on the right hand side and then go to table of contents. And this needs to be toggled on to use this feature. The next tip to use Notion really quickly is to learn the various duplication methods. If you want to duplicate blocks, so let's say that we have a checkbox here and you want to do this really fast, you can type Command or Control D in this block in order to add a lot of them. So this can save a lot of time if you don't know how to copy what you have here like this. Another really useful way to duplicate really fast is to hold option and then drag. So you can create as many as you need like this. And this can also be a really useful way to duplicate your blocks. Then one more thing I wanted to show is if you highlight them all just like we did before and then Command or Control D, you're going to create even more of them. So this is another really useful way for duplication. So the next thing I wanted to discuss is moving forward and backwards from where you were in the page. And this can help you save a lot of time if you frequently get lost in your workspace. One way is to use the arrows on this top part here. You can go like this. The other method is to use a keyboard shortcut where you can hit Command and then the bracket like this. And then you can hit the other bracket to go back. So what this looks like is Command or Control plus the bracket. And this is going to allow you to go backwards. The other method is Command or Control and then the other bracket if you want to go forward. So make sure to really learn this one. This can really save you a lot of time so you can go really quickly back and forth between different pages. The next useful feature is a very small one, but that can really save you a lot of time, and that is to mark your pages as favorite if that's something that you use really frequently. This might already be obvious, but you can just go to this star marker here, which is going to allow you to see it on the sidebar like this. So this is just a really useful way if you have like a habit tracker you want to keep track of all the time, or any kind of favorite pages, to just choose key pages, maybe 3 to 5 that you really have as your favorite, and mark them with the star. So the next thing to note if you want to use Notion a lot faster is to learn Markdown. Markdown is a lightweight markup language that allows users to add formatting elements to plain text documents without using HTML tags or a formal text editor. So what this means in a Notion context is that you don't need to use the selector. So normally if you have a text and you wanted to bold this, you can highlight and then change it to bold. The other option is to use Markdown. So let's say that we put these two star symbols text and then you put another two, it's going to automatically bold it. So if you learn this really quickly, then it's going to be way faster than if you constantly have to select and then choose things, or even if you have to just highlight this and use the keyboard shortcut, which is Command B. It's way faster if you know that you can just simply type text like this and then it's going to do this. One of the most easiest things to learn for this one is the heading. So if you do something like this hash sign and then heading 1, or you could do 2 hash signs, heading 2, and then 3 hash signs, heading 3. So all of these are super useful. They're all laid out in the shortcut cheat sheet, so make sure to check those out. So the next really quick feature that's going to save you a lot of time if you don't already use this is just to really know your slash commands. So the slash commands sometimes make it a little bit more time consuming because you have to type out more text, but this also is the most intuitive. So if you wanted to do like a linked view database, you can simply type slash linked and then go to linked view database. If you wanted to create, let's say, a calendar, all you have to do is type slash calendar and everything. So as long as you know exactly what you want, it's going to make it a lot easier if you type slash and then embed, for example, or even slash Figma if you know that there's a Figma embed. So all of these slash commands are highly recommended to learn. Finally, the last really quick tip I have that's going to save you a lot of time is to undo. So let's say that you have a mistake here and you want to undo this. You can type Command or Control Z just to go backwards. So just knowing that can save you a lot of time so that you can undo certain things that if you didn't like, you can just type Command or Control Z to remove that change. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to grab the free Notion shortcut cheat sheet in the description below. Let me know which of these techniques are your favorites. Feel free to comment with any questions or thoughts, and I hope to see you all in the next video.